Hi, I'm Naomi, and today we are going to go over one of Camtasia's fun new features, the motion path. We will look at this in three stages. The first will be the basics. The second will be for a fun surfing video. Then, of course, the third will cover all of these bouncing tennis balls. Now, if you are new here and you find this information we're about to learn of value to you, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Okay, let's first get a quick basic understanding of how the motion path works. We see here we have four squares on the left side of the screen, text on the right. We are going to use a motion path on part one to bring it underneath the text. Let's go to Visual Effects, scroll down to the Motion Path tool, drag it onto the part one annotation callout. Let's first take a close look at this. On the canvas, we see a simple Bezier curved line. On the track, we see the motion path with a start point and an end point. If we click on the start point on the track, it is also selected on the canvas. The same for the end point. You can adjust the curvature of the line by using the point's handle. You will see in the properties panel, you can also quickly adjust the handles to have a curve or straight line. You can move either point where you want on the canvas. Adjustments can be made to the motion path by moving it on the assets, adjusting the timing by moving the points out or in. If you want to add different stops along the path, move your playhead out to the time frame you want. Right-click on the motion path and select Add Motion Point at Playhead. Click on that point either on the path or on the canvas. I find it easier to keep track of busy motion paths by first clicking on the track. You can now move that point on the path to any location you want. Notice in the properties line type, you have more choices with this point, since it is not a start or end point. You can add as many points along the path as you want. Let's say you want a pause in the movement and keep the box here. Move the playhead off the motion point a couple frames away, then right-click on the motion path and select Split Motion Path at Playhead. You now have a second part of the path with a start and end, which you can move further down and make adjustments. Let's see how this box moves, pauses, then continues on the path. We see we need to adjust this endpoint closer to the motion point on the canvas. We click on the point on the path, it is selected on the canvas, and we can make our adjustment. Let's remove these paths as I want to show you one quick thing before we move on to our surfer dude. The default anchor point of all assets on your tracks is the center. In most cases, you won't need to change it. This is where your motion path points anchor to, the center. However, you can move that anchor point to wherever you want by holding your control key down first, then clicking on the anchor and moving it to a different location. Now, when you add the motion path, you will see that is where the motion points are anchored to. Let's take what we have learned with the basics and see how we can use text with a surfer riding the waves. I downloaded this video from Pexels and have provided the link in the description below if you would like to practice along with me. Okay, what our objective here is to keep the text, "Surfer Dude," near the crest a good portion of the time, following the surfer. The first thing I will do is go to Visual Effects and add the motion path to the text callout. Next, what I like to do is stretch the path the full length of where I want it to be animated. Then I will move to the starting point where I want it to begin and the end point where I want it to end. As I showed in the first section of training, I am going to move the playhead forward and each place I want the text to move, add a motion point and adjust the text for that area. I'll do the first at normal speed so you get the idea, then speed it up slightly for the rest of the points. You'll get the hang of this as you practice. A couple notes. The first round doesn't have to be perfect. Once we have set the first set, we'll play through it, and any location the movement is not smooth or is too fast, we will adjust the points. Also notice how I adjust the motion point handles to add more gentle curves in various places. Here's some soothing beach music while you watch this process. Okay, now the last step to this is to play it through without scrubbing through it and see how it looks naturally. Is there any place that needs to be adjusted as far as the curve, the timing of the movements? Sometimes if they are too close together, it can look odd. Okay, that looks good enough for this demonstration. You can keep finessing it until it is perfect for you. I'll click on the finish editing or click off the track. Now it's time to show how to work with multiple paths with the bouncing, ricocheting tennis balls. This technique works very well with green screen, where you can separate your on-camera talent from the background. However, it can be done without green screen, although it would need a few more steps with media mat. Today, I'll be demonstrating with only the green screen. As you can see, I have already removed the green screen and added my background. I have a tennis ball image which I will add to the tracks and resize. I'll also extend this to the same length of my video thumbnails for the basics and the surfer dude. I'll add the motion path and extend that to almost the full length of the tennis ball asset. I'm going to stop about 4 seconds from the end as I will be adding additional tennis balls and will start each tennis ball about 1 second after the one before it. I will move the start point where I want the ball to start and the end point to where I want the ball to end. Now, as before, I will move my playhead along each section of the motion path and add a motion point, then adjust it as I want, along with the line type if necessary. What you will notice here is initially, I'm not worried about the ball being in front of me. My main focus is to have the ball moving along the motion path. I will handle the sections where I want the ball to go behind me once I have finished adjusting the path as I want. I'll put a motion blur on this at 10%. Okay. Now I will go to the specific areas I want the ball to go behind me, split the front and end of those sections, then move those sections to the track directly under me or your on-screen talent. I'll then group all of the top tennis balls together and then group all of the bottom tennis balls together. I'll now add the markers to the groups to help line them up if anything is accidentally moved out of alignment. Now here is the fun part. I'll simply duplicate the top group and move it over by 1 second. I'll add a color tint to the new ball. I'll do the same with the bottom group. You'll notice I am renaming each of the groups so there is no confusion. It's a good habit to always rename your groups. I'll add 3 more tracks with the ball motion paths. And this is what we now have. I would love to hear from you on how you think you will use the Camtasia Motion Path in your own videos. Leave a comment below letting me know how you envision using this, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask me. If you haven't done so already, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell. Now, I think you will probably enjoy watching one of these videos next. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.